Yes, so today we have arranged to a special session on budget 2020-21 that was recently given by our finance minister. And let us try to go through this budget and understand with our examination perspective. Okay, not as an economist, not as an critic to the government, or let's say not as an independent evaluator. Rather, we have to focus on the examination perspective only. Okay, so we'll keep our let's say analysis restricted to that path only. Okay, so whatever important for your prelims examination, mains examination, and let's say abhi interview bhi hai kuch logon ke, so some questions can be asked in the interview also. So in this manner we'll proceed. And many of you may have read provisions given in the budget and yes, understood some provisions, but many students are first timers, they are attempting this examination for the first time. So let us try to go through let's say basics also. Okay, so first of all we need to understand how to read this budget for our examination perspective, or let's say preparation. UPSC Civil Services examination, and there are three broad aspects while understanding or reading this budget. First and foremost is understanding of some key important significant concepts related to budget, and those concepts can be related to your economy section of syllabus as well as polity section of syllabus. Okay, so polity section is not directly related to this budget, right? This is part of some basic concept in polity syllabus. Like there is annual financial statement is there, or budget passage procedure is there, or there are some important terms like vote on account or interim budget. Now this type of terms have been asked in your prelims examination. So we have to understand those terms also. Okay, and some economic terms directly related to your budget. Okay, so those terms in the economy or your syllabus of economy section can be related to tax proposals, or some key terms like tax buoyancy, or let's say tax expenditure. There was a question in your mains examination in 2013, what do you understand by tax expenditure? And explain it with the example of housing sector. Such kind of questions have been asked in your examination. So understanding key concept helps in your prelims as well as mains examination. Okay, so we will try to cover such maximum terms in this lecture, and then we will see the highlights of budget. Okay, so both are important, because second term in this let's say while reading this budget is understanding the objectives and highlights of the budget. And yes, in 2017 there was question that 2017-18 budget had objective of transform, energize India, like this, and what are the proposal in that budget which seeks to achieve this objective. So such kind of question can be asked in your mains examination, and therefore understanding these proposals or let's say highlights of budget are also important for your mains perspective also. Okay, so understanding some concepts, understanding some let's say highlights of this particular budget, and then in the end we will have some trend analysis in terms of macroeconomic indicators. Okay, so which are these macroeconomic indicators? Let's say GDP growth rate is there, or let's say revenue, government's revenue is there, or let's say expenditure, the way government is allocating this expenditure or let's say budget for certain sectors in our economy. Okay, whether it is increasing, whether it is decreasing. Let's say question was asked on the gender budget in 2016 mains examination. So there was the question on current status of gender budget in India. So you need to mention that year's proposal of budget, or let's say gender budget. कितना परसेंट अलोकेशन हुआ है विमेन स्पेसिफिक जो बजट में, तो उसको हम जेंडर बजट बोलते, राइट? सो दैट काइंड ऑफ फैक्ट्स आर ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट, एंड देन द ट्रेंड वेदर इट इज इंक्रीजिंग और डिक्रीजिंग. ओके, सो सच काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स वी विल गो थ्रू इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर. आर यू गेटिंग दिस? ओके, एंड लेट्स से इन बिटवीन इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क दैट ऑल्सो. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस हैव बीन आस्क्ड इन योर प्रीलिम्स एज वेल एज मेन्स एग्जामिनेशन. ओके, सो आफ्टर रीडिंग दिस क्वेश्चन लेट अस नॉट ट्राई टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन. लेट अस नॉट ट्राई टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन एटलीस्ट फर्स्ट टाइमर्स, बिकॉज दे मे फील दैट ये क्या है ऐसे टाइप का. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड विच टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस कैन बी लेट से ऑलरेडी आस्क्ड इन योर एग्जामिनेशन एंड देन द प्रिपरेशन, सो दैट यू कैन प्रिपेयर यूर सेल्फ इन अ पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन. फाइन, सो लुक एट दिस क्वेश्चन. सर्विस टैक्स इज और एन. ओके, सो सच टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन, लेट से ऑल टाइप ऑफ टैक्सेस and they are given in your budget also. There are some tax proposals, there are some changes in the taxation policy of the government, and yes, in news in general also you may find such type of news also. Okay, so service tax is there, or we know that it is always in news, GST, right? Goods and services tax. So this year in 2019, what was question in mains examination? Enumerate the taxes which are subsumed under GST, right? So this was very factual question, and actually when the GST was rolled out, it was in news at that time in 2017, but question was asked in 2019. So we need to be well prepared about important taxes, both direct as well as indirect. ओके, सो लेट्स से सर्विस टैक्स के बदले वहां पे कोई भी दूसरा टैक्स पूछा जा सकता है. विच गवर्नमेंट लिवीज एंड विच गवर्नमेंट कलेक्ट्स दैट टैक्स. ओके, सो इन दिस मैनर वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द टैक्सेस ऑल्सो. ओके, लेट अस नॉट आंसर दिस राइट नाउ. पूरा जब पढ़ाई होगा ना, तब हम फिर से ये क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करने की कोशिश करेंगे. ओके, वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन एंड वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन. बजट अगर प्रेजेंट होता है देन हु प्रिपेयर्स दिस बजट, राइट? वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू योर पॉलिटी सेक्शन. लेट्स से प्रिपरेशन ऑफ बजट, ये तो पता होना चाहिए, राइट? सच काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द कंसेप्ट फिस्कल स्टिमुलस. इट इज ऑलवेज इन न्यूज, fiscal stimulus, right? Even in recent times, before presenting this budget, there was discussion on the present government should focus on giving a stimulus package to boost the economic growth, right? So what constitutes this fiscal let's say stimulus, uska meaning pucha hai prelims examination, right? Let us not try to solve this, just go through the type of questions that have been asked. Now there was concept asked in 2010, at the same time what constitute fiscal stimulus package, 1, 2, 3 points. Okay, so that is also important to understand. Again, this is very conceptual question, what constitutes fiscal stimulus. Pehle to humne kya dekha hai, ye concept pucha tha, अब क्या पूछा है थोड़ा फैक्चुअल. फाइन, नाउ दिस वॉज वेरी ट्रिकी क्वेश्चन दैट वॉज आस्क्ड इन 2011, वोट ऑन अकाउंट एंड इंटरिम बजट. दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स फॉर योर पॉलिटी सेक्शन प्रिपरेशन ऑल्सो, राइट? वोट ऑन अकाउंट एंड इंटरिम बजट, वॉट इज फुल फ्लेज बजट, वॉट इज डिमांड फॉर ग्रांट्स, all these things are very important concepts, and we will understand all this concept today only, and then we will solve these questions. Okay. Now fiscal deficit, this was in news this year also, and the question says that yes, there has been a debate on, let's say, persistent deficit budget year after year. Then which of the following action can be taken by the government to reduce this deficit? Again, very conceptual question. Okay, to answer this question, we have to understand what constitutes fiscal deficit. And then only we can answer this question, that which actions taken by the government can reduce or increase this fiscal deficit. Okay, so this is again important concept: fiscal deficit, revenue deficit, effective revenue deficit, primary deficit. All these concepts we'll today understand about them, and such type of question can be dealt by you. So after prelims questions, some mains questions related to your budget section. Let us try to read them, which type of questions are asked in your mains examination from 2013. See, what is the meaning of tax expenditure? Then FRBM Act, again it was in news recently. So already the question was asked in mains examination. Okay, and then the gender budgeting question 2016, and then the overall highlights of the budget with the objective of transform, energize and clean India. Okay, so question can be specific, like question number 5. Look at the question number 5. Important changes introduced in the respect of long term capital gains tax and DDT. It is very specific question. And look at the question number 4. Now this is looking at overall budget, right? All the provisions related to, let's say, to achieve the objective that is given in the budget. Right. So what was the, let's say, objective given by our finance minister this time? Or this budget, objective of this budget? Yes, to increase, or let's say improve, ease of living for our people. Let's say ease of living, and in that direction all the budget is directed. So the similar kind of question can be expected, right? Similar kind of question can be expected. So let us try to understand some basic concepts related to your budget, and then we will go to highlights of the budget. Okay, we will simultaneously understand both from prelims perspective as well as mains perspective, highlights of the budget. Okay, yes. So first of all, the constitutional provisions. We know that the article 112 talks about annual financial statement, right? And then the president shall let's say put this financial statement or in front of, or let's say on the floor of two houses in the parliament, and then we can understand that different provisions in our constitutions, like no demand for grant shall be made except on the recommendation of president, or no money shall be withdrawn from the Consolidated Fund of India except under the appropriation made by law. So all these provisions are there in our constitution related to budget. We will understand what is appropriation, or let's say demand for grant. All these concepts we will try to cover in the next part. But these statements are important for your prelims perspective. Directly 1, 2, 3 statements will be given, and let's say which of the above statement is correct. Okay, and one such question was, or let's say statement was there: Parliament can reduce or abolish a tax but cannot increase it. Those who have analyzed the previous year question papers, they may remember this statement. Parliament can reduce or abolish a tax but cannot increase it. So such type of statements will be asked in your prelims examination. composition of budget. We know that budget estimates of revenue and expenditure of this year, and then revised estimates of closing year, or let's say previous year, right? And then the tax proposals, or let's say economic policy of the government in that the coming year. And same way, we can understand that composition of budget, the same question in prelims can be expected. Which among the following is, which of the following is included in the budget or annual financial statement of the government? 1, 2, 3 statements will be given, and the similar type of question can be asked. Now, one note for your information, or let's say additional information, we know that in 2017 budget, the railway budget was merged with general budget, right? But when it was separated? In 1921, on the recommendation of which committee? Acworth committee. So this is given in M. Lakshmikant, but for prelims perspective it is important, and many students may not know that, or newcomers, that railway budget was separate. सोचिए 2017 के बाद जो स्टूडेंट्स आए हैं प्रिपरेशन करने के लिए, दे मे नॉट नो दिस. अर्लियर देर वॉज सेपरेट रेलवे बजट एंड रेल बजट, सॉरी जनरल बजट. ओके, सो अर्लियर इट वॉज सेपरेट, नाउ इट इज मर्ज्ड, एंड नाउ देर इज ओनली जनरल बजट. ओके, एंड रेलवे बजट इज पार्ट ऑफ नाउ जनरल बजट. अगेन कंसेप्ट, two important concepts: expenditure charged upon and expenditure made from, and what constitutes this expenditure. First, expenditure charged upon Consolidated Fund of India, expenditure charged upon and made from. Okay, so charged upon consists of some important, let's say, salaries of president, or let's say judges of Supreme Court and High Court, their pensions, allowances, all these things are included in charged upon, and these expenditures are non-votable in the parliament. Means what? This is the non-votable part of your budget. Again, important concept. Okay, so parliament, or let's say MPs, cannot vote on this. Sorry, acha ulta likh diya, fine, upar ka non votable hai, sorry. Okay, so jo bhi charged upon expenditure hota hai, that is non votable, and made from, and that is from the appropriation bill that is passed by the parliament, and then it is made from the Consolidated Fund of India. So this is important concept. Let us try to understand charged upon aisa separate kyun kiya gaya hai, why it is separated. Yes, it should not be subjected to, let's say, all the executives, they are elected after, let's say, every 5 years, right? And if it is put to their whims and fancies, then they can increase or reduce the salary of CJI. So basically, it is for maintaining independence of some important constitutional positions and offices. क्यों किया गया है ये? To maintain the independence of important constitutional offices and positions, like CAG is there, or president, vice president, and their salaries, and judges, high court and supreme court, all these are included in it. Okay, so that they can work in independent manner, they need not to worry about their salaries, allowances and pensions, rather so they can work in independent manner. from quality aspect, again it is important. Stages, there are 6 stages in the budget passing process, and how it goes one by one, let us go through briefly. First is presentation of budget, and yes, the finance minister presents this budget on the floor of Lok Sabha, and that budget speech, it consists of, let's say, presentation of budget, which is followed by next stage, general discussion on the budget. And in this general discussion, let's say there is no voting, or let's say no detailed discussion on the provisions in the budget, only general discussion. Okay, and next step is important, that scrutiny by departmental standing committees. So there are 24 departmental standing committees in the parliament, and those committees now will scrutinize these budgets in sectorial manner. Let's say agriculture sector is there, industrial sector is there, infrastructure sector is there. So all these, let's say, demands put forward by the government in the budget, they will analyze in depth. Okay. So there is a gap of 3 to 4 weeks now after this general discussion. There is a recess for the parliamentary session, or let's say budget session. And again, in the fourth stage, they reassemble for, let's say, voting on demands for grants. Now, demands for grants, what do you understand by demands for grants? Now, demands for grants are nothing but, let's say, some sectoral demands of the government for expenditure in that year. Okay, so these are nothing but the sectoral demands put forward by the government for expenditure. And when they are voted and passed, they become grants. So that's why the name demands for grants. So prelims ke liye kuch information honi chahiye ki they are debated and voted in the ministry-wise manner. One by one, each ministry is taken, and each demand for grant voted separately, one by one. Okay, and after, let's say, at this stage, there will be a detailed discussion by the member of parliaments on the budget. Okay, so earlier there was general discussion. Now, detailed discussion is allowed, and then voting takes place on each, let's say, demand for grants. And there can be motions moved by the MPs, and these motions are called as cut motions. Okay, cut motions. There are 3 types of cut motions, right? Kaun se hai? Policy cut, economic cut, token cut, right? क्या होता है पॉलिसी कट? यस, बेसिकली द पार्लियामेंट सेज दैट योर पॉलिसी इज इनइफेक्टिव, इनइफिशिएंट, एंड इट मे गिव अल्टरनेटिव पॉलिसी टू योर पॉलिसी और द गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसी, एंड देयरफॉर रिड्यूसिंग द एक्सपेंडिचर और व्हाट एवर द डिमांड यू हैव मेड टू ₹1. नाउ दैट इज पॉलिसी कट मोशन. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, पूरा का पूरा पॉलिसी ही रिप्लेस करने की बात होती है. सो रिड्यूसिंग द एक्सपेंडिचर ऑन दैट पॉलिसी टू ₹1. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज इकोनॉमिक कट मोशन. इकोनॉमिक कट मोशन सजेस्ट दैट देर इज अनवांटेड, लेट्स से, वेस्टेज ऑफ मनी इन द पॉलिसी, एंड वी कैन रिड्यूस दैट विद द सर्टन अमाउंट. ओके, so that cut amount will be specified amount put forward in the motion, and that will be called as economic cut. And third one is token cut. Yes, mujhe pasand nahi aayi hai aapki policy, aise hi, right, I don't like your policy, and therefore I want this policy to be, let's say, reduced, or its expenditure to be reduced to 100 रुपीज, 100. ओके, सो ये आपको चीजें पता होनी चाहिए कट मोशन के बारे में. प्रीलिम्स के लिए आपको क्वेश्चंस आ सकता है, फाइन. एंड देन द fifth stage is appropriation or passing of appropriation bill, and sixth stage is passing of finance bill. Now there is a difference between appropriation bill and finance bill. Okay, again in prelims examination such question can be asked, or even in interview some basic concept can be asked related to economy. Okay, so what is appropriation bill? Basically appropriation is, yes, expenditure part of the, yes, so whatever the government want, let's say budget estimates in terms of expenditure in that year, so that needs to be appropriated from the consolidated fund of India. Okay, and after passing of this bill only the government can spend even a single rupee. After passing of this appropriation bill, then only the government is allowed to spend money from the consolidated fund of India. Okay, and then the next is finance bill. Finance bill is nothing but the overall budget, or it consists of both receipts as well as, let's say, expenditure and the revised estimates of previous year. Everything is submitted in there. Fine. So this was about passing of bill and some concepts. Vote on account. The question was asked in prelims examination. Let us try to understand vote on account. Just now I have told that appropriation, the government cannot spend any money out of consolidated fund without passing this appropriation bill. But passing of this appropriation bill takes too much time, and government requires some money for expenditure for this 2-3 months. Okay, and therefore in our constitution itself it has been provided that such kind of vote on account, okay, this is the tool where the government can seek, or let's say pass vote on account, so as to have certain amount of expenditure before passing appropriation bill. Before passing appropriation bill. Okay, so this is vote on account, and this is completely related to government's expenditure part for 2-3 months. Okay, this is completely related to government's expenditure part out of consolidated fund of India. Fine, we will come back to that question. Okay, same thing. And when it is passed, after the general discussion stage, second stage. Fine, the difference between interim budget and full-fledged budget, last year we had both. Last year we had both. Kab hua tha? In February, Mr. Piyush Goyal presented interim budget, and in July, 5th July, yes, Ms. Nirmala Sitharaman, the new finance minister, presented the full-fledged budget for 2019-20. So what is interim budget? Interim budget is given by the outgoing government in its last year, or let's say before general elections. The outgoing government before general elections. Abhi general elections kab? April mein hue, right? And May mein naya government assume kar diya. But beech mein teen mahine ka period bach gaya, right? So for that 3-4 months, whatever the budget expenditure as well as revenue, both are included in interim budget. So it is a mini budget, but let's say a mini budget, or let's say small budget, there is no big ticket reforms are, let's say, introduced by the government. That is, let's say, mutual understanding. Hai na? Ki naya government aayega to sab change kar dega na? So a convention ban gaya. There is convention that no big ticket reforms are introduced in interim budget. Fine. So interim budget consists of both receipts as well as expenditure. It consists of both receipts as well as expenditure. Rather, vote on account was only related to expenditure part. Now, there was one line in that question that interim budget is given by caretaker government. Now, there is a difference between the budget given or interim budget given by the government this year, 2019, and caretaker government. Who is caretaker government? Yes. Basically, caretaker government is that government which assumes the power until the newly elected government, let's say, or newly elected government assumes the power. वो जो छोटा सा time period होता है, तो उस time period के लिए taking care, ना caretaker, rather, so caretaker government is that government which takes care of the government, let's say administration, governance part, till the newly elected government assumes the power. देखा जाए तो ऐसे अभी generally होता नहीं है क्योंकि 5 साल के पहले ही जनरल इलेक्शन शेड्यूल हो जाते हैं एंड न्यूली इलेक्टेड गवर्नमेंट एज्यूम्स द लेट्स से गवर्नमेंट. ओके, सो हैव यू अंडरस्टूड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन वोट ऑन अकाउंट, इंटरिम बजट एंड फुल फ्लेज बजट? ओके, सो लेट अस गो बैक टू दैट क्वेश्चन. एक्चुअली तभी के तभी सॉल्व हो जाता है, तब इजिली समझ में आता है. Now try to solve this question. Yes, kya hai answer? Two only. Now it is easy. Now you can tackle such kind of question in examination. Okay, so your concepts need to be clear and question can be tricky. उस साल क्या हुआ, caretaker government जो था वो students ने seriously नहीं लिया था, समझ में नहीं आया था, both mark करके आए हुए. ठीक है, so I'm just explaining you that what kind of mistake that a student can make while attempting such question. And yes, ये आपने पढ़ा होगा पॉलिटी में. नाउ द यूपीएससी हैज गॉन लेट से वन स्टेप अहेड इन आस्किंग द क्वेश्चन लेट से एट द हायर डेप्थ लेवल, ग्रेटर डेप्थ लेवल. सो वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड और नो और मग अप सम आर्टिकल नंबर्स ऑल्सो. ओके, सो कंसेप्चुअली वी अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज कंसोलिडेटेड फंड ऑफ इंडिया, व्हाट इज कंटिंजेंसी फंड ऑफ इंडिया, व्हाट इज पब्लिक अकाउंट्स ऑफ इंडिया. But yes, one step ahead, you need to know that two funds are included in Article 266 and then one is in 267. Okay, so I presume that you know what is Consolidated Fund of India. No, no. Okay, let's try to understand briefly. Consolidated Fund of India is that fund wherein the government's all type of revenue, let's say tax revenue, majorly tax revenue or the revenue out of disinvestment through PSUs or let's say revenue from the interest for the loans advanced by the government. So all these things are let's say included in consolidated fund. Whatever the revenue, major part generated by the government is included in consolidated fund of India. Okay. And then other important is public accounts of India, public account. So whatever the government announces that saving schemes, small saving schemes or pension schemes, all these schemes, those let's say deposits by individuals, PPF hota hai, saving schemes hota hai government ka, right? So all these deposits are included in public account of India. Okay, and contingency fund, basically this is allocated and it is under the President of India, let's say executive ke hand mein hota hai directly. So contingency, as the name suggests, apatkalin. Theek hai? So whatever let's say unforeseen events happening in the country and which needs large amount of money within a short period of time, then government sanctions that money from the contingency fund of India, and later on it should be passed in the parliament. Try to understand that not a single penny that government can use without the approval of parliament. Okay, ye aapke dimag mein fix kar do. Fine. So amount wo facts nahi necessary hai. Okay, so theek hai. Then other important concept is what constitutes capital account, what constitutes revenue account in the budget. Okay, so ab tak humne thoda polity ke concept dekhe, ab thoda economy ke concept dekhte. So what constitutes revenue account? So revenue account, again there will be two parts, one receipts, second expenditure. Okay, receipts matlab jo revenue aa raha hai, expenditure matlab jo ja raha hai. But on revenue account, okay, so what will be the receipts on revenue account? There can be tax revenue and there can be non-tax revenue. There can be tax revenue and there can be non-tax revenue. Example of non-tax revenue: dividends, disinvestment, okay, or interest. But interest kiske upar? Loans jo diye hue. Sorry, fines, penalties, all these things will be there. Even the services provided by the government and those charges, yes, all these things will be included. Try to understand, government is not giving its services free of cost. So, na, kam hota hai cost, but free of cost nahi deta hai, to wo bhi paisa wahan pe jata hai. Fine. And what is revenue expenditure? Revenue expenditure, jo aap IAS banoge, to aapki salary jo hai, so that is revenue expenditure of the government. So spend it wisely. Theek hai. So ye kya hai? So all the salaries of civil servants or government servants, whatever the allowances that government gives, let's say housing allowance, all these things are covered under revenue expenditure. Revenue expenditure. Now try to understand, even in revenue expenditure there can be tax expenditure and non-tax expenditure. And that tax expenditure wala jo question tha, uske baare mein abhi samajh ke lete. Okay, there was question on tax expenditure. Tax expenditure kya hota hai? We know that the government gives housing allowance, government gives tax incentives for taking a loan to buy the house. Agar mujhe ghar lena hai, then I will go to the bank. Okay, and there will be a scheme given by the government that yes, any person with certain, let's say, income level who opt for housing loan, then he will be given certain tax waiver. He will be given some tax waiver. Okay, so such kind of tax waiver is nothing but revenue loss on the part of government. Rather, we can say that is the revenue expenditure, and that is tax expenditure by the government. If I want to buy a house, I will take loan, and the government promotes this kind of schemes. Why? Because housing sector is that kind of sector which has very high amount of spillover effect in the economy. Spillover effect on the other sectors. It boosts the economic growth. And therefore, government promotes this. Hame lalchate hai, ghar lo. Theek hai, loan saste mein denge. Fine. So, that is nothing but tax expenditure. Even the housing rent allowances, HRA. Okay, so whatever the house we take on the rent, that is, let's say, some part of that rent is given by the government as HRA. That is nothing but the revenue foregone on the part of government, and that is called as tax expenditure. There are two types, or let's say part of the tax expenditure by taking example of housing sector. One is, just now I have explained that the tax incentives, tax waiver can be given by the government, those who are opting for housing loan. Second thing is that suppose there is a 10 lakh loan to be taken to buy a house, then government may say that yes, we will provide you 3 lakhs and you pay 7 lakh. We will provide you 3 lakh and government will provide 7 lakh. What is Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana scheme? It has one such option that the interest on that loan, that particular amount, I guess 1.5 lakh or 2 lakh or 2.5 lakh, kuch to amount hai, that is directly credited to your account, or let's say that loan account, not your account, directly to that loan account. Now what is that? The government is spending, but try to understand, jo first, abhi jo maine bataya wo scheme hai, the government is let's say least opting for this scheme because it has risk for the government. Okay, because the person may default, the person may default, or he may not use that money for that, let's say buying that house or whatever the intention of that person. Okay, rather government is, let's say, more opting towards that tax waiver, because directly the obligation of paying tax is removed from you and now you will be obliged to buy that house, to opt for that tax waiver. Dusra kuch nahi kar sakte aap. Okay, so that second part is, again we can say that important. Question was saying that housing sector, take example as housing sector. To ye teen char aap example do, rent wala ek do, ye do example usme dene. So have you understood? Tax expenditure and non-tax expenditure is whatever the government is let's say spending on salaries and all these things. Okay, subsidies, all these things are given by the government, so that becomes the non-tax expenditure. Have you understood this? Okay, now the revenue expenditure, this is completed. Capital account, next one. Again it has capital receipts and capital expenditure. Now capital receipts are those receipts, let's say jo capital assets create karne mein hum use karne wale. Okay, so whatever the receipts which are related to creation of capital assets, capital ye word isliye use kiya gaya, or let's say productive assets. What are capital assets? Those are productive assets. So let's say the government is taking loan, or let's say external commercial borrowings, all these things come under capital account, and the government is supposed to spend that money in creation of productive assets. Okay, second important thing is capital expenditure. Now whatever the government that will spend this money on the creating productive assets, let's like infrastructure sector, housing structure, or let's say road construction, aviation, railways. So all these sectors, whatever the government spends, that has let's say cyclical effect or spillover effect on the other sectors and overall economic growth. So we can say that to some extent revenue expenditure is non-productive. Again, for prelims examination, types of deficits in the budget, fiscal deficit. Now fiscal deficit suggests the overall picture of the government, that what extra amount of financing that government needed for its expenditure this year, extra amount of money that it had to borrow to finance its expenditure. that is nothing but fiscal deficit. Okay, so formula dekho, total expenditure of the government minus total income of the government. So everything is included in expenditure and everything is included in income, right? So that becomes the fiscal deficit. Now fiscal deficit is related to primary deficit. Look at the fourth one first. Primary deficit, this is very different concept. Now primary deficit is nothing but removing the interest payments from fiscal deficit. And now whatever the remaining money will be effectively used by the government to source its expenditure. Okay, that is primary deficit. That is primary deficit. Dono mein difference kya hai? Interest payments. Government kya karta hai? Bahut sare loans leta hai na. So whatever the interest that government has to pay in the previous year, this year nahi na, previous year mein jo pay karne pade the, that is to be subtracted from the fiscal deficit. That becomes the, because effectively that much amount the government will have now to source its finances, or let's say expenditure. So that is primary deficit. And then other two concepts, revenue deficit and effective revenue deficit. So revenue deficit is about revenue account. Abhi jo humne dekha tha. So whatever the revenue expenditure minus receipts. So that becomes revenue expenditure. But other concept is effective revenue deficit. The difference between revenue deficit and grants for creation of capital assets. So that should be subtracted from the revenue deficit. Why? Because whatever the grants given for the production, creating capital assets, basically that is productive money, right? That cannot be considered for the revenue purpose. ठीक है, ये एक नया term 2011 में introduce किया गया था. This was introduced in 2011 in India through FRBM, changes in FRBM. So this is again we can say that used in India itself, revenue, revenue, effective revenue deficit, and that will be less than revenue deficit. So basically this effective revenue deficit should be zero, ideally zero. Rather we should move that revenue deficit should be zero. Pahle humne target kya karna hai? Effective revenue deficit should be zero, and then we can target that revenue deficit should be zero. Barabar hai na? Whatever the liabilities of the government and whatever the government has borrowed jo expenditure ke liye, to wo same hona chahiye na. Revenue ke liye agar government borrow karna shuru kar de, matlab aapki salary pay karne ke liye agar government borrow karna shuru kar de, then that will be crisis. That is not good economics. That is not good economics. So that's why we have to eliminate this revenue deficit. Fine? Clear, sir? Okay.